In recent months, I've been in tune with my body. I've been keeping tabs on the way I feel, and I've noticed there are many areas that I need to heal. This realization began with a feeling in my breast. Between my ribs and near where my heart rests, I felt a burning of orange energy inside of my chest. I took some time to keep track of when this feeling would flare. I found the orange glow in me would grow if I was angry. And it would burn when I fell in and out of love. Hatred and love have a lot in common. Both are all-consuming forest fires of obsession with another person. You have to care a lot about a person to hate them. You adorn your enemy with your attention when you cannot help but think of their actions. In this way, the lines of love and hate are easily blurred. And in that moment of time when I couldn't find the words to say I love you too, I realized I had fallen into hate towards my own bloodline. Now hear me out, it took reasons and time for me to feel this way. Somewhere along the line, something went wrong. This feeling didn't fester in one day, but it was accelerated after I came out as gay. You didn't know how to love me in the ways I needed, and my reaction was like the nomadic peoples of old, how they fled as soon as they were told of fire. I packed my belongings and I left home. I decided to roam new lands and beliefs. I never settled or planted my roots in anything or anyone. The fear of fire I now call trauma has made me a nomadic soul. My desert life empty, never satisfied with morning dew. But the heat in my heart reminded me what it was like to not be cold. The hate in my heart reminded me what it was like to be loved by you. I have always been mindful of archetypes, so I know I might be cast as the prodigal son. You are praying for me to come back to your home and religion, but I didn't leave with money, and I have enough self-worth to know that the home I left cannot be the same home I returned to. I am growing in unexpected ways on my own, but the forest floor needs to regrow before the nomad returns from being alone, and I return to you. So in the time being, I will work on myself for my own health. Harboring hatred inherently harms the host, until it's passed down a generation, which happens the most. The embers in my body stay burning most of the time. Flames will escape my mouth on occasion, but the greatest toll is always my mind. How will I find the time to focus on the people who hate me just so my pain feels validated? If no one hates me, what else do I have to be mad at? At some point, the lack of love I've received made anger more reliable. And now it's a game I play that, quite frankly, I enjoy most days. It's addictive and anger has me hooked. I fear the peace of equality because I found false identity in being a minority. If I am equal and treated fairly, what else do I have to fight for? I am a soldier scarred from culture war, triggered by bombs but unable to give up the rush they bring. I believe those who are not loved turn to the drug of hate, because it's better than feeling nothing. Hate was the sedative that made your eyes glassy and cold, as I cried for you to listen and to hold me. The harm you received was the harm you gave, but I am learning to be free. I was told freedom would come with distance, but it turned into resistance to the idea that there is still good in you. I prefer when you're a monster, so then I don't have to love you. But you're broken most of all, and while I must protect myself, hating you would take its toll. I thought freedom would look like apathy, but my anger proved that I would always care. I could be 1,000 miles from the nearest body, but your legacy in my life would always be there. True freedom isn't hating those who abandon us. It is forgiving them, though they might not ever ask for it. True forgiveness isn't giving allowance for harm. It's being at peace with the past. I don't like myself most days, and I thought it was because of the way you trained me to think. I can never undo the words planted in me by you, that were watered by my own self-hatred. But perhaps if I begin to practice seeing the good in others, in you, I will learn how to see the good in myself. And that will be the day I finally return home. Because I will find that home is being at peace in my own body.